parties or something, but she was just a wonderful woman. I'm sure that you know that. I want to just read this morning out of Lamentations. This is Israel kind of just sharing their thoughts as they were in a place of torment. And I thought it was just kind of applicable today. The Lord is good to those who depend on Him, to those who search for Him. So it is good to wait quietly for the salvation from the Lord. And it is good for people to submit at an early age to the yoke of His discipline. For no one is abandoned by the Lord forever, though He brings grief, He also shows compassion because of the greatness of His unfailing love. Let's just pray. Lord, as we gather this morning, Lord, to celebrate the life of Dorothy, Lord, may we realize that, Father, what we are experiencing is just part of life. Death, Lord, came upon us because of a failure in the garden, Lord, but You have overcome death, Lord, and I just ask that You would just help us to understand that, Lord. I just pray that You would bring comfort to the family, Lord. Just ask that You would just, even by the presence of these, their friends and neighbors, Lord, and relatives, that You would just be able to comfort them, Lord, and bring back the memories, the good times that they had together. And realize, Lord, that as long as we have those memories, Dorothy will not be gone. She'll always be with us. We ask this in Your name. Amen. I want to read one more scripture out of Romans this morning. Can anything ever separate us from Christ's love? Does it mean He no longer loves us if we have trouble or calamity, or are persecuted or hungry or destitute or in danger or threatened with death? No. Despite all these things, overwhelming victory is ours through Christ who loved us. And I am convinced that nothing can ever separate us from God's love, neither death nor life, neither angels or demons, neither our fears for today or our worries about tomorrow. Not even the powers of hell can separate us from God's love. No power in the sky above or in the earth below, indeed, nothing in the creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God that is revealed in Christ Jesus our Lord. Dorothy Jean Hedrick died Sunday, January 14, 2024, at Aspen Park of Cascadia in Moscow. She was born on December 25, 1930, to Maddie Gaines Clark, delivered in Moscow by Dr. Charles Gritman. She has been a lifelong area resident and graduated from Pullman High School in 1950. She moved to Potlatch, where she married Grover Lyle Hedrick in 1951. Dorothy will be laid to rest, or has been laid to rest, beside Lyle in the Rock Creek Cemetery. Dorothy moved to Blaine Street in Moscow in 1991. She was always a homemaker and has been a granger for more than 70 years, first in the Rock Creek Grange and later in the Princeton Grange. She enjoyed her monthly pinochle with her Rock Creek neighbors and friends even after she moved to Moscow. She enjoyed keeping in touch with family and friends through notes and cards, texting, phone calls, emails, and Facebook. She lived at Paradise Creek Health and Rehabilitation of Cascadia, formerly Good Samaritan, from August 2022 until December 2023, then moved to Aspen Park. The family would like to thank Isaac July, for his ongoing work and friendship, Judy Cornish and Laura Moore, and their staff at Palouse Dementia Care for their daily care and relationships, as well as the staff at Good Samaritan Village and Aspen Park of Cascadia for their work, and the numerous family members for everyone's contribution to Dorothy's last feisty years of life. She was preceded in death by her husband, Lyle Hedrick, companions Ray Bell and Charlie Bauer, sons-in-law John Sweeney of Potlatch and Jack Gilbert of Potlatch. Dorothy leaves behind two daughters, Ruth Sweeney of Potlatch and Patty Gilbert of Potlatch, two sons, Ken Hedrick and his wife Linda of Newport, Washington, and Jim Hud Hedrick of Garfield, Washington. Six granddaughters, Julie Hedrick of Moscow, Michelle Harris and her husband Troy of Meade, Washington, Kendra Mendoza of Newport, Washington, Stephanie Herbert and her husband Tim of Lewiston, Carol Clay and her husband Eddie of Woodstock, Georgia. Kelly Atkinson, husband and her husband Rob of Moscow, and 8 great-grandchildren. Just want to take time, if anyone wants to say anything about Dortha, a memory. I don't think you actually have to come up here. You could just do it from where you're at. But if you have any thoughts or any remembrances of her that you think would be fitting, I want to just give you a chance to share.
Just a short one. She taught us to work with fractions without us really realizing it. She would say, oh, go, we'll make some chocolate chip cookies. Double the recipe. So we had to figure that out. But the ones I didn't like were when she said, well, we're baking a cake, so make a recipe and a half. So we learned our fractions that way.
I just want to say thank you to all the family. Obviously, you guys all know who you are. We've worked a lot for Grandma. I mean, I helped with the obituary, so we've talked as far as all the staff that were involved, but also all the family, you know, Ruth and Jim and Ken, Kendra, Michelle, Judy, the great-grandkids, the grandkids. Obviously, we worked hard, but Grandma was shown love to the end. Obviously, every time I visited her at Good Sam or Aspen Park, everybody knew that she was well-loved by how many staff and how many family members were coming to visit her. So I just want to say thank you. You know, we worked all the way to the end, and even after she had passed, Ruth and I still have work to do, obviously. The great-grands still have work to do. You know, there's still plenty of work to do, but Grandma was well loved, and obviously the staff and all the nursing homes where she lived and the care agencies, you guys all knew that she was well loved by all of the family members. So just thank you guys for all of your work and dedication to help care for Grandma, because not everybody has family that would step up, and 12 family members moving her out of Good Sam, and whew, we sure did.
The gravy is a whole nother thing. matter how long, but she has her ways. And one of my favorite stories, which I didn't get on the recording today, but me and Stephanie were going out to see her mom at Potlatch, and so me and Bethany were in the back, and Stephanie was driving Grandma's car, and I have a short little video of it, but Grandma was telling Stephanie how to get there. And she's like, Grandma, I know where I'm going. I'm not Judy, because I don't know there, so she had to tell me where to go and where to turn, and are you sure we're going the right way? And she's like, I've lived your whole life. Of course I know where I'm going. I'm like, you're going down some weird back road that are you sure we're gonna get there? But Stephanie knows the back roads. Stephanie knows where to go, and she, you know, there's obviously many ways from Moscow to get to Potlatch. So Stephanie's like, you know, don't tell me, Grandma, I got this. So me and Bethany were laughing in the back, and then she started getting onto it. She's like, okay, so she started jokingly, okay, now turn here. Remember, you know, go down the highway this way, and we laugh. And yes, Grandma, we all know where to go.
I've got a small tack on for that. We actually have a joke, Grandma, drive her off because of.
Well, I guess you'll have time to share your stories afterwards. I just want to close here with just talking about death. The Bible says that death is the last enemy to be defeated. You know, it's one of those things that sneaks up on us, kind of like a thief or a robber. We don't really expect it. Even when we see people getting older, we don't really seem to deal with it that well. But the thing of it is with death, it being an enemy, you can prepare for it, just like you can prepare for any enemy that you want to fight. You know, you can practice, you can train, you can do whatever. But the Bible says, Jesus says, come unto me, all you that labor and heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn of me, for I am meek and lowly of heart, and you shall find rest unto your soul. And, you know, he's just inviting us to take the life that he has so that when the enemy of death comes, we can be standing beside him, and he'll say, nope, they're not yours, they're mine. And so I want to just leave you with that. I remember a quote that I think my mother-in-law put in a Bible that she gave me one time, and it's this, only one life, 'twill soon be passed. Only what's done for Christ will last. So let's pray. Almighty God, in your great love, you crafted us by your hand. And you breathed your life into us by your spirit. Although, Lord, we may be a rebellious people, you did not abandon us to our sin. In your tender mercy, you sent your son Jesus to restore us in your image. In obedience to your will, he gave up his life for us, bearing in his body our sins upon the cross. By your mighty power, you raised him from the grave and exalted him to the throne of glory. Rejoicing in his victory this morning and trusting in your promise to make alive all who turn to Christ, we commend Dorothy to your mercy, and we join with all your faithful people and the whole company of heaven in the one unending song of praise. Glory and wisdom and honor and power be to our God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to have some music and some video at this time while we're getting ready to, I guess, talk and visit. So anyway, this concludes the service for Dorothy.
I just wanted to say one more thing. I don't know if Anita Fallon is here today. Oh, okay. Hi. She had contacted me to find out about getting a hold of Grandma's family, because obviously, I don't know, Anita, if you wanted to talk about her Grange service, but Grandma was in Grange for 71 years, and she was an officer up until the time of her death, so she was still actively involved. So I don't know how many of the great-grands or the grandkids, I know Ruth's involved in a lot of activities and social groups, but Grandma was obviously the leader in that too, so I'm glad that, Anita, you are here, because obviously the certificates and the dedication and just Grandma's time at Grange, she talked about Grange all the time.
Thank you. trumpet of the Lord shall sound, and time shall be no more. And the morning breaks eternal bright and fair. When the saved on earth shall gather over on the other shore, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there. When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll.
I And we got bus.